Welcome to week 51 of Soaping 101. This week, we are doing a much-requested tutorial on coffee soap. Let's begin with a question that some of you may or may not know the answer to. What do all of these products have in common? They all contain caffeine. Caffeine is widely used in skin creams and cosmetics because it is a vasodilator, which simply means that it constricts blood cells. Caffeine also reduces redness, firms and tightens the surface of your skin through constriction, thus reducing the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles, and it also dehydrates fatty cells, causing water to dissipate from the skin's surface, thus reducing the appearance of cellulite. But what about caffeine in soap? Because caffeine is a water-soluble compound, it can be used in soap for an added wake-up feeling. While showering, the caffeine is dissolved along with the soap and becomes infused throughout the batter. As the lather rests on your skin, you may note a tingling feeling. This is the caffeine waking up your skin. Who wouldn't want to use a perk-me-up soap with wrinkle, puffiness, and cellulite-reducing qualities? So let's create some. Our recipe today consists of 5.5 ounces of olive oil, 5.5 ounces of palm kernel oil, 4 ounces of coconut oil, 1 ounce of castor, 5.9 ounces of strongly brewed coffee, 2.4 ounces of lye, 2 grams of anhydrous caffeine, and I'll put the link below where you can purchase this, and 1 teaspoon of finely ground coffee. So let's begin. This is the anhydrous caffeine powder. Each gram is equal to 3 strong cups of coffee. It dissolves best in hot water. Just a little is needed, and then we'll set it aside as we work on our lye solution. This coffee is double strength and has been frozen so that it will not become burnt by the lye. We add our lye just a little bit at a time until all of it becomes dissolved with the coffee. Our oils have been sitting and are now at room temperature. Time to add our lye solution. Many of you ask why my batter has bubbles. Well, these are simply air bubbles caused by my powerful stick blender. In goes our caffeine solution. Because the scent of the coffee does not make it through the saponification process, we are adding a blend of coffee bean fragrance oil and peppermint essential oil, an eye-opening combination. I am separating out a small portion to lighten with titanium dioxide. This is purely for aesthetic purposes. Now we add 1 teaspoon of coffee grinds. My measuring spoon is 1/4 of a teaspoon, so I will add 4 spoonfuls. The ground coffee will help with the cellulite and skin exfoliation. Time to pour our soap. I'm using Wilton's 4-loaf cavity pan. Each cavity creates a 1-pound loaf of soap. I'll add a link below to where you can buy it. In goes our batter, blended with the coffee grinds, and our liquid batter. We will alternate between the two until our mold is filled. Then we will give it a bit of a swirl with a skewer. And finally, the back of a spoon will add texture and interest to the top of our soap. After letting it sit for 24 hours, our soap has been cut into bars. Here's our triple shot coffee soap. Please be advised, this soap is not for children. Give it a try. Let me know how it works for you. Well, that's it for this week. Next time we'll be making celebration soap. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next week.